Last year, during the summer of 2022, I finally got around to watching the Canadian cult classics FUBAR 1 and FUBAR 2. After the release of FUBAR 2, both Diener and Terry went their separate ways, but eventually reunited in 2017 for FUBAR Age of Computer. Since then, the duo split up and made it official on social media in 2023. However, throughout those years, Diener focused on his passion for music. Outside of the silver screen, he formed his long-talked-about band Nightseeker, mentioned many times in both FUBAR movies. Together in 2018, they recorded their album, 3069 A Space Rock Sex Odyssey, and went on tour, playing in cities such as Montreal, Calgary, Toronto, and more. Researching the band, I discovered that all members, excluding Diener, reside in Montreal. So, I individually contacted each member to attempt to interview them and talk about their time in Nightseeker. This is The Pursuit of Nightseeker.
I met Diener through when he moved to Montreal when we were like teenagers. So we did a bunch of punk bands together.
I saw one video of you guys from like 2008. You like spray painted in like
chrome. Yeah, that was our band called CPC Gangbang.
I saw his band play. I was like, oh, it's the guy from that movie, you know. Went to go see his band. It was CPC Gangbang.
Yeah.
And totally not Diener. The show I saw, they were playing in Barfly, like, you know, the little
okay.
tiny bar.
Yeah.
And there was 10 people there, and Diener got totally tall, got totally naked.
Awesome. Like, okay, so basically you knew about Diener before, you knew of him before joining the band, obviously.
Yeah, I was a fan of the movie.
Okay,
absolutely.
Okay, awesome.
So it was kind of, yeah,
was it like
starstruck kind of thing. Like, yeah, I met the guys through the movie, the second movie, where I just did some backup vocals. And then next thing I know, I got an email, oh, I want to start a band, go on tour, pay you $100 a show.
So okay.
It's like, sounds awesome. Free trip, get paid, come back with cash.
Mm-hmm.
Everything's paid for. So yeah, that's how it started. But then it evolved into actually being a band where we wrote an album and recorded it.
We did, yeah, one tour after the second movie came out. We did a tour with Monster Truck out west a lot.
Yeah.
Like, I think we did 14 dates in Alberta, which is pretty wild.
It was 16 dates.
Okay.
It was 18, maybe. I think we did 16 just in Alberta. We played,
wow,
like, every town in Alberta.
Okay.
And then NBC and all that. And then after that, we did the TV show for Viceland. And then we toured that.
Okay.
And then we did Ontario. Some shows at West, and that was with Poof and Ian Wilson, who's in Metallica.
Beers contributed, you know.
Okay.
Pilsner, I like it.
The bars would sell out pallets of it, like massive amounts of it. So we definitely drank a lot on the road. There was some nights where they would have like in industrial quantities of it, and so yeah, we didn't have a lot of it going around, and it was, you know, it definitely like loosen the mood.
Every rose has its
thorn. She does like shotgunning and stuff. Like, I suck at shotgunning, but Diener is really good at it.
Up she goes, you crack her, and down she comes. Look, that's a perfect fucking shotgun.
And he enjoys it, and it just that there's like a lot of people who want him to shotgun.
At some point, it gets really hard on him because people were literally lined up outside the hotel the next morning to shotgun beers.
Are
with
you
him.
Serious?
And it's like 8 in the morning when we're gonna hit the road. And
Jesus
like,
Christ!
Shotgun a beer. Like, so it got to him. You know, at some point, it's like it's too much. He had to hide from people.
Like, I've seen him shotgun like massive amounts, like 10 beers or something, and.
Seven shotguns today.
He can hold it together, so he definitely is like a professional party monster.
There's one show we played, it was April 20th, so it's 420, in London, Ontario. Yeah, I don't know if you've ever been there, but the whole town was like, it's just like wasted, you know?
Like the audience had been drinking since the afternoon, so the crowd was often pretty out of control. huge muscle guy dressed up as a as Terry.
And we played, I can't remember the name of the venue, but it was like a multi-stage venue. Okay. And we were in like the big, big room. Like these, what do we call it? Like rafters or whatever? Like those like supports that ran probably a good 80 feet in the air above the room.
I was playing and then the bouncer came straight at me, he was running. And then I remember being like, what the hell's going on? And he almost fell on my head because he was trying to do like an Eddie Vedder hanging from the rafters. Yeah.
People were climbing up the scaffolding and then like tightrope walking over those things, like over the crowd while we're playing.
And the bouncer just caught him. So we even have a little bit of that.
So he's talking about the same show then, because that show was out of control. It was really out of control. A couple music videos too, though. I don't know if you've seen them. It'd be really hard to find too. Like maybe they didn't really do anything with it again.
What were the concepts behind those videos?
Oh, there's like this demon guys, like the Night Seeker guys, like comes out of like a grave. And, I don't know. You'll have to see it. Was in Shotgun Beer, I don't know, we smash a bunch of shit and Shotgun Beer, but it's pretty simple.
Probably not as Night Seeker, but it might be some formation of most likely the same guys if everybody's available. So
anything's possible.
I like that.
Paul did ask me if, because they submitted it to South by Southwest. He said if they get that, maybe we could play a show down there.
Around Diener, that's more up to Diener. Because I know Diener has a movie coming out called Diener 89. So we did the soundtrack music.
Yeah.
I don't play on all of it. The other guys do. Poof and Ian play on a lot of it.
You never know when's the last or when whatever. Like the movie, the Diener 89. That came kind of out of nowhere too.
Mm-hmm.
He texted me in July, I think. Oh, hey, September, would you be down to record an album for like for the movie and like the bass tracks, like the background music and stuff like that?
Yeah.
And I was like, sounds cool. And as we watched the movie, we did it on the spot.
I mean, watch the movies. They're great. They're hilarious. Check out all the bands affiliated. The TV show's cool. Oh, check out Diener 89 and Poof. The drummer's got a bunch of bands. I got bands, Ian from Metallion Rules.
We started in 2002 or 2003, so we've been around for like 20 years. Well, we played shows with, like Roy's band, Poof's band.
They're the shit. They're like awesome, so that's great. Something to check out and,
Enjoy Diener 89. I think it's gonna be pretty awesome. The music we did in is pretty badass, so, yeah, and check out Metallion. We got a new album last year, Beyond the Wall. And yeah, that's about it. Thanks a lot to you for the interview and stuff.
No problem.
Unfortunately, after countless failed attempts, we couldn't reach Poof, the drummer of Night Seeker. Even after many hours of research, there wasn't much I could find about him. Based off info given to me by Roy, Poof played in bands such as Smash Up Derby, Red Mass with him, and possibly still plays with The Rejectors and Hoodrats.